This call is now being recorded.
We will discuss now other mechanisms by which we can reduce these interferences. Whenever there are electrical networks or electrical components, the word grounding plays an important role. Now, what exactly this grounding means? Even in the labs, we have seen how exactly grounding helps in normalizing the signals and reducing the spurious signals or noise signals. This practically also we have seen in the lab. If the grounding is not proper, sometimes the voltages are not stable. As a result, your readings are also not correct. So under such cases, first thing what we do is check the ground connections. The entire circuit or all the devices which you have connected in the circuit are properly grounded or no. By changing one or two ground connections, we have got good results. Now, what exactly this grounding means? So ground is basically in all the electronic networks is a point or an equipotential plane that serves as a reference for the voltages in a circuit or a system. This we have tried even in network analysis, where by changing the ground point, how exactly slight variation in the currents or voltages happen. So if all the points or all the devices in this system design, all the devices, say if you are using a function generator or an AC generator or a power supply or sensing network or some Arduino board, all their ground connections or all their circuits common points should be maintained at the same reference potential. And this reference potential, we call it as ground. If they are not maintained at the same point, then every circuit is going to have its own reference potential. If every unit or every circuit in your system is going to have its own reference point, then there does not exist any common point with respect to which or with reference to which you are measuring the voltages. So always there is a disturbance or that difference in the potential between two units causes errors in the final readings. And the system also gets confused which one to be taken as reference. So under such cases, this common ground or equipotential plane plays a very important role. So when grounding a circuit or a system, we must minimize the noise voltages generated by currents flowing between circuits through a shared impedance. Now, what exactly is the meaning of this? Suppose I have one circuit, say Arduino or the sensing network. Another one is the power supply by which it is powered. If these two units are not maintained at the same potential, if there exists between these two a voltage, then whatever measurements I make with the sensor network, those voltages, I cannot compare them with the ones from the power supply. To avoid this, what should be done is they should be connected by a common wire, which is preferably a zero resistance wire. Practically, it is not so, but ideally, for the time being, we'll consider it as a zero voltage point. Then, by grounding like this, both the circuits have common reference point. All the measurements are going to be with reference to or with respect to this common reference point. When you have this kind of a network, now we'll come to what is the discrepancy here. If these two circuits are at a distance, then you will be making connection with a long wire. And long wire, as it is, because it has got some length, so naturally it is going to have some resistance. Maybe less, but definitely it is going to have some resistance. As a result of this resistance, the currents, when they are going to flow through this wire, they produce some potential difference. This potential gets transmitted to the next stage. And usually this is the instrumentation amplifier stage. To one of the terminals, whether it is a non-inverting terminal or an inverting terminal, this voltage is going to get appearing there. As a result, the difference voltage, which you think or you assume that it is from only exclusively from the sensor, it has this component due to the voltage difference between the ground potentials. Now, this has to be somehow avoided. So, we must avoid ground loops. So, like this long wire or ground loops should be avoided because they are susceptible to magnetic interference and to voltage differences between the different grounding points. If they are too long, if they form coils, then there is a possibility of even the magnetic field which is getting generated, which is equal to integration of B dot S. Or they may form, if they are too long, they may form some kind of a capacitance between this wire and the actual ground. So this also can induce some voltage, or some voltage drop can be developed between this wire and the ground. So these are the three reasons why such long wires should be avoided. So there are different mechanisms to suit the needs of different circuits or different ways of connection by which one can connect the ground. Now, what are the different ways we will see now? So here, there are three ways in which our circuit can be connected. See, unit 1, unit 2, and unit 3. Say one could be a sensor, one could be a power supply, another one could be a simple instrumentation amplifier. Now, all these three, when they are connected like this, shorted here, and then one common ground, what happens between ground and this circuit? You have this impedance, say Z1. And between the first and the second unit, you have the impedance Z2. Between the second and the third, you have impedance Z3. And naturally, current is going to flow here when it is connected to ground. So I1, I2, I3 respectively be the currents flowing in unit 1, unit 2, and unit 3. Now here at this point, what happens? We'll go back to the circuit here. See, at ground, what currents you get? I1 plus I2 plus I3 into Z1. At this point, you get into Z1, because only this is coming into picture if I consider this point. In this mechanism, the potential at this point is going to be I1 plus I2 plus I3 into Z1. Z1 is the impedance, whatever is available here. So this impedance is going to be affecting the ground. In the second type of configuration, where we have all of them are brought simultaneously to a single point. Here, what was the point? All the three were connected to different points, and between them there were some impedances. To minimize that, to avoid this kind of a situation, we are connecting in the second one all the three units to a common ground. This is what usually you do in the lab, all of them to a power supply point, function generator or the circuit or the power supply or CRO, all of them you give them to a single power supply point. This is somewhat like this. So here what is happening? Z1 is coming here. So here one junction is formed here. The second junction is formed here. And third one is the ground. Now we'll see what happens at this point. So a potential VB, which is equal to considering junction 1 here. I1 plus I2 plus I3, all three currents are flowing. And at this point, Z1 is the only impedance which is coming into picture. Plus at the second next point, I2 plus I3 into Z2 is coming. And at this point, there is no potential because it is directly connected to ground. So here, VB, which is equal to sum of these three currents into this, plus sum of these two currents into the impedance from the second unit. These are going to be available here. In the third type, what we have? Multiple points parallel to connected to ground. So parallelly they are connected to ground. So here individual impedances like this are connected to different points, but all of them are grounded. Now what is happening here? Slight difference in this connection and this connection. For us, when we assume that short means always zero resistance, all these three connections look similar or rather same. But in practice, if the wires or the leads are too long, they are contributing to the impedance, then these considerations have to be made. Now in the third case, what is happening? VC is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 into Z1 at this point. And here at this point, I2 plus I3 into Z2 at this point. And at this point, where the cursor is pointing, here I3 into Z3. So these are the three potentials which are for these three combinations getting developed. Now, these three combinations are commonly used as per the need. There is no fixed rule as such, like which one should be used. Now you measure these voltages VA, VB, VC, and depending upon what is your requirement, which suits your requirement, any one of this grounding can be used.